Hello, welcome back. Today we're going to go ahead and talk about finding the internal forces in a beam. So if you look at the beam we have right here, the with the loading, and in this beam we want to locate, we want to calculate the internal forces, which is the shear moment, and at point C and point D. First thing we're going to do with anything, as always, I have talked about. We're going to take the beam and we're going to draw the free body diagram. So I draw the free body diagram right here, and we have a two reaction here, BY and BX, and we have a reaction at AY. And let's calculate the reaction forces first. I'm going to go ahead and take a moment about point B. Summation moment about point B is equal to zero. Counterclockwise is positive. So I'm going to be, this is going to be AY time. That distance is 2 meter, 2 meter, 6. So minus AY multiplied by 6. And then the next one I have is a concentrated load. That's 15, been converted to a concentrated load, which is 30. And that's going to be positive. So it's going to be plus 30. And that's going to be time, this distance is going to be 1 foot from here. And therefore, it's going to be 5 feet. Time 5 feet. And then we have the 15, so the 15 also is going to go ahead and be positive. Plus, let me come back down here, plus 15 multiplied by that distance right here is 2 meter. Very good. And then don't forget about the moment. The moment is going to be minus 30 kilonewton is equal to zero, and AY comes out to, then, so this is 25 kilonewton. So if I do summation FOY is equal to zero, BY should come out to 30 and 45 minus 20, that comes out to 20 kilonewton. So that comes out to 20 right here. And summation FX is equal to zero, BX comes out zero. Okay, now we got all the reaction out of the way. One thing we want to find out the internal force at point C. Let's do the cut the beam right here at point C. So when we cut the beam right here at point C, what we're going to have, we had the reaction came out to 25 kilonewton, we knew that. And then we're going to have the concentrated force, it comes out to 30, and it's 1 meter apart from the reaction force. Then when we cut it, we're going to replace the cut with the shear and moment. And we have a VC and MC. To calculate the VC and MC, what we're going to do is let's do a summation FOY first for VC. Summation FOY is equal to zero. Going up is positive. In here, I have 25. And then minus VC, minus 30, minus VC is equal to zero. So VC going to come out to minus five kilonewton. So our force really should be pointing up rather than pointing down. Okay, let's find the moment C. That's one answer. Summation moment about point C is equal to zero. And we have 25 minus 25 multiplied by 2 plus 30 multiplied by 1. And minus MC is equal to zero, and therefore MC gonna come out to meter per meter. Okay, so the sign at point C, let's go at point D, and we're gonna go ahead, take them right here, and make the cut. The point D is just before these loading. That's why I don't have the 15 kilonewton and the moment. So all we have, when we cut it just before the loading right here, we're going to end up with the shear and moment and force in a horizontal direction. And of course, this it's going to be, this distance is going to be 2 meters right here. And our summation FOY comes out to zero. Let's do that first. We're going to have VD plus BY, and BY plus 20 is equal to zero. And therefore, therefore Vd is equal minus 20 kilonewton. I mean, there, it's going down. So the moment is going to probably be reversed on the other side. And then, so the moment is going to be summation moment about point D is equal zero. And the way we have it, that it's going to be negative moment, so minus MD. And then we're going to have By time 2, which is plus 20 time 2 is equal zero. That's all we have. So MD comes out to 40 kilo Newton meter. Really, that's it.